Okay, so our last video is going to be on quadratic equations or higher polynomial equations and how to solve for the variable in these type of equations. First off, let me just introduce the topic of single variable polynomials. These are equations in math that have the following form: ax to the n plus bx to the n minus 1 and so on, and at the end you have C here, which is representing a constant term, just a number, and the whole thing is equal to 0. So n can be any whole number, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. A, B, C are just numbers, which in math are normally called constants. And so an example of a single variable polynomial will be the one that's written at the very bottom there in purple, which is 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, as some of you might know, when n is equal to 2, then the equation is called a quadratic equation, and it has the following form: ax squared plus bx plus c equals to 0. You'll often see these type of equations show up in equilibrium type problems in Chem 12. In other words, when you set up your problems, it will end up a lot of times in the end that you have to solve some kind of a polynomial type equation. And what happens is you usually want to solve for x, which is the variable in your equation. X most often represents molarity or concentration terms. So if your equation is a quadratic equation, then the easiest way to solve for x would be to just use the quadratic formula. However, there's an alternative method you can use for quadratic or higher polynomial equations, and that's called successive approximation. This works, like I said, for quadratic equation, but it also works for higher polynomials, for example, x to the third power, x to the fourth power, and so on. Let's now briefly talk about the quadratic formula. You all should have seen this before. Ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. That's the polynomial, and the quadratic formula is x1 and 2 is given by minus b, b coming from here, plus minus the square root of b squared, b again from here, minus 4a times c, everything divided by 2a. So if you plug in the value of a, b, and c into your equation, you should get two values of x as a answer. This needs to be memorized for this class because there will be quite a few times when it'd be convenient if you remember this formula to solve the quadratic equation in front of you. Let's do a quick example here. So let's say you set up your equation in an equilibrium type problem and it ends up being x squared minus 4x minus 8 equals 0. So in order to use the quadratic equation, then you would just say x12 is equal to minus b, b in this case is minus 4, so that's what goes in there in that parentheses, plus minus square root of b squared, which is minus 4 squared, plus, I should say minus there, there's a typo there, it should be minus 4 times 1, which is a, the coefficient for a, and then minus 8, which is the coefficient for c, and then divided by 2a. Now, even though there's that little typo there, when you actually go ahead and finish the calculation, you should get either 5.5 or negative 1.5 as your answer. Now, in chemistry, a lot of times it's fairly easy to distinguish which one is the correct answer because usually x, like I said earlier, represent concentration or molarity. So it doesn't make sense to have a negative molarity or concentration, so then the positive number would be the one that makes sense. Okay? So in other words, negative 1.5 can be gotten rid of. Now the second method is called successive approximation. Successive approximation is really a method that relies on making a guess or an approximation for the value of x. And this is really useful for higher polynomials because for quadratic you can always use the quadratic equation. These are the steps in successive approximation. First, you start by guessing what an initial value of x might be. You might start with x equals 0, for example. You make a small x assumption or whatever. But you have to guess what the initial value of x might be. And then what you do is you take that guess and you substitute it into your polynomial. And for every x that you have in that polynomial, except one of the x's. And usually, the highest power x is the one that you don't substitute. Let me show you an example. So let's say you have a polynomial of the form ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d equal to 0 as written at the bottom of the screen. And you can see that what you're going to try to do is say, let's assume that x is equal to 0 in my equation. If I do that, what would happen? So you're going to substitute that 0 value into the x squared as well as the x, but then you're not going to substitute it into the x cubed. So you're going to leave the x cubed term the whatever it is, and then try to solve for x from x cubed. And whatever that solution is, if that's also equal to 0, that means that you're done. If it's not equal to 0, then you're going to repeat this step again and again until at some point, whatever you're guessing, the value of x you guess is the same as the value of x that you solve. Okay, let's do a quick example on this, and this is from the Zumdahl textbook. And like I said earlier, before we actually go to the example, that if you don't get the same answer, you have to keep repeating the step until you get the same answer for the guess and the solve value of x. This is what we refer to as convergence. So here's the example from the Zumdahl textbook. Let's say you set up an equation, again from an equilibrium type of problem, and this is your equation here at the top. X squared plus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5x minus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 9 is equal to 0. This, by the way, is a very common type of equation in equilibrium problems. Now, if you don't want to use the quadratic formula in this case, you can go ahead and try to do your successive approximation. In this case, your first guess is circled by this purple color, and it's 2 times 10 to the minus 5. Okay? If you what we did here was to take this value and substitute it back to the value of x, so you can see now that your equation becomes x squared plus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5 times x, but x is now this number, so you put it right here, minus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 9 equals 0. And then what you do is go ahead and solve for what x would be, okay, because you still have one that's unknown, so you're going to solve for that, and you find that x squared is equal to this, and so x is equal to this number right here, circle in red. So in other words, your purple is your guess value, your red is your solve value. You can see that the two numbers are not the same. One is 2, the other one is 3.7 times 10 to the minus 5. So we don't have convergence in this case. So we need to repeat the successive approximation with a second step. Here's the continuation of our previous problem. So this is what we found as our first solution in step 1. When we guess, we got this number as our solution. Now this becomes our input for the second guess. So in other words, we take the solution from step 1 and use it as a guess for the second step. Okay? And then what we do is just, we just take that guess value and again substitute it back into the original equation, x squared plus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5x, but the x now is this number, minus 1.8 times 10 to the minus 9 equals 0, and we solve for x again. If you do that, what you get is this number right here, which is circled in yellow, and that is the solve x value, or the solution for the second step, which is 3.3 times 10 to the minus 5. And again, if you look at the two numbers, the guess versus the solve, or the calculated, you see that they're getting closer now. One is 3.7, the other one is 3.3. So it's getting closer, so I say almost here, but we're not quite there yet. So you have to go ahead and keep repeating this step. Now, of course, what you want to do is you're going to use the solve value for the second step and use that as the guessed value for the third step. So you're going to take 3.3, put it in back in the equation, and solve for x. And what you get is 3.5 now, which is circled in red. So if you compare your third step result, the guess versus the solve, you get 3.3 and 3.5. Again, they're really getting very, very close to the correct answer. Really getting close to convergence. So of course now the next step, I should say, should be to just take the guess value or the solve value for the previous step and input it in. And so we took 3.5 times 10 to the minus 5, which is our previous answer, and put it back in the fourth step. And when we operated it on the function, we get 3.5 times 10 to the minus 5 as our answer as well. In other words, this is the sign that we've reached convergence. Okay? So in other words, we're done with our successive approximation. So that's how you would solve a polynomial using successive approximation.